In the last video, we counted how many sites are within an area of around 1 kilometer around the, it's precisely 1 kilometer around lakes. This time we would like to do something else, and this time I would like to make some summary statistics over the different cantons. More precisely, I want to know in which canton we have the earliest date in the mean and in which canton we have the latest date in the mean. So we need to summarize over several of these points within the circumference of one of the polygons. We can do that by searching here for connect attributes by position. So we have two things that are more or less named the same. So with that, you can, with the this version here, you can just transfer attributes, but with this version, with Zusammenfassung, you can make summary statistics over that. So with summary, actually in English it would be called summary. So again, that's a functionality that you can only achieve or access via the toolbox. If I click that, I have here the dialog that asks me for the input layer. So the input layer is actually our cantonal borders. And the layer that we would like to connect with that, that's our C14 dates within the range of Switzerland. Again, we select this cut by geometric predicate. And now we can specify which fields should be summarized. We don't need to do that. In that case, all fields are summarized. But we want to have specifically only the BP value, so the uncalibrated C14 value, to be summarized. And now we can specify what kind of statistics we would like to do here. And I said I want to have the mean, so that's Durchschnitt here in German. I could also use the median, the standard deviation, and you can see that there's a lot of different options available. I click on OK because I just want to have the mean. Here it says remove all data sets that could not be connected. So for example, if we don't have any C14 dates within a layer, this would result in removal of these layers. But we leave it like that because we want to have all the cantons in the end. Then again, temporary layer, yes. And I want to have that open immediately afterwards, so I can click on start. And I can close it down. And now we can see we have again the cantons here in the foreground, now in a very nice brown color. And if I now go to the attribute table, you can see here is a new column, BP mean, which means the mean BP value of all the Z14 dates that are in there. So don't ask me how this is useful in later analyses, but it serves just as an example. Now, if we have that, we can start coloring the different cantons according to this BP value. So this is again a task for properties, symbology, and we have seen already the single symbol, that's what currently is active. Categorize, we've seen that if we want to have different categories visualized. Now we get to go to graduated, so we can use some numeric values to specify the position within a color ramp. So here the standard color ramp is selected with this from white to red. I'm fine with that. I could change that to something else, greens, magma, or yeah, spectral. Oh, let's go to spectral. And then we have to select what field should be used. So we have here BP mean as the only numeric field that's available. So we select that. Now we have to click on classify. And now we get different classes of values. We can also change here the way how these classes are made, or actually change the values by hand in by double clicking on this and change the values here. But currently I'm fine with that. I can also have more classes. That might be interesting. So I can enlarge the number of classes here to get a finer resolution in the different colors. I can click on OK, and now you can see here the different colors representing different mean BP ranges, BP dates. Blue means the earlier ones, red means the later ones. So we can see here some kind of structure going on. Not very clear, so in the south there are some early dates, but also some cantons in the north have rather early dates, while here we probably don't have any dates. If I put this, we have some few here. So these are rather late dates. Okay, now you know how you can visualize these values, create them in the first place as summary values, and then visualize them using this graduated color scheme from QGIS.